Hey friends, welcome back to Yoga with Mike. I'm so glad to have you here. Today we're going to be going through a short but sweet flow together. We're going to be doing a lot of invigorating poses to start off the practice. We're going to build up the energy. We're going to do a side crow at the peak of our practice, so it should be a lot of fun. And then we're going to cool it down, get in a nice stretch to close off. So I hope you enjoy. You won't need any props besides your body and your mat. When you're ready, let's start in child's pose. Soften the shoulders. Ground through the tips of the fingers. Anchor through the palms of the hands to send your hips back towards the heels. Find stillness. Allow these first couple moments of our practice to be very simple. There's nothing we're striving for. There's nothing we're trying to accomplish. Just focus on bringing your awareness into your body. Notice how you're feeling today on a physical level. Notice how you're feeling today on an emotional level. Keeping in mind there's no right way to feel. There's no wrong way to feel. You're just observing with an equanimous mind. From this place of awareness, begin to focus in on your breath. Take a deep inhale through the nose, fill up the belly, feel the air as it rushes into your body. As you exhale, sigh it out your mouth, soften, deflate. Take two more deep breaths. Feeling each inhale as the air comes in. Each exhale as the air goes out. Last breath. At the bottom of your exhale, start to slide your palms back towards your body. Rock your weight forward, tabletop position. Spread the fingers. Ground down through the palms. Try and get your weight so it's equally distributed through all four corners of your body. A couple cat-cows. Inhale, drop the belly down as you lift the chin up. Exhale, tuck the tailbone around the spine, drop the head. These should feel nice and fluid as you do them. Flowing with the breath, inhale, drop the belly, opening through the front of the neck. And exhale, grounding through your palms, dropping the head. And last time, inhale, belly drops, eye gaze goes up, and exhale, gazing down as you round the spine. Good, and then come back to a flat back in our tabletop position. Slide the palms forward, tuck the toes straight into downward facing dog. Take any movements that feel good, maybe pedal the feet out, rock side to side, shake the head yes, shake it no. Really a lot of freedom in these first couple moments of our practice. Take one more breath to find stillness. Once you find stillness, anchor through the fingertips. Press through the arms, hug your biceps towards your ears so that you feel the biceps start to rotate up towards the ceiling. Take a deep inhale. Sigh it out the mouth. Gaze between your thumbs, tiptoe the feet all the way to your hands, coming into ragdoll pose, opposite hand grabs opposite elbow. Soften the knees. Rock side to side. A
Good. And then release your elbows. So we'll be moving through these poses a little bit faster today since it's a shorter class. Go ahead and plant your left hand in between your feet. Take a slight bend into your left knee. Keep your right leg straight. Inhale, reach your right arm up and open. Gaze up towards your right fingertips. Deep breath in. Exhale. Lower down, switch hands, right hand comes down, slight bend in the right knee, left knee is straight, inhale, extend up, gaze up, and exhale, coming back down. Good, inhale, halfway lift, lengthen the spine, lengthen through the head, exhale, fold forward. Inhale, root to rise, mountain pose. Extend the fingertips up. Press the palms together as you gaze up to the thumbs. Exhale, hands to heart center. Close the eyes. Feel the feet grounding down. Deep breath in through the nose. And out through the nose. We'll move into three rounds of sun salutations. Inhale, sweep the arms up, press the palms together. And exhale, hinge from the hips as you fold forward. Inhale, lengthen the spine, halfway lift. Exhale, plant the palms, step it back, high plank position. From here, we're going to move either into a chaturanga, keeping the knees lifted, or feel free to drop the knees. Inhale, cobra or upward facing dog, whatever is comfortable. This is your first one, so no need to push it. As you exhale, take it back downward facing dog, pausing in stillness. Take three rounds of breath. Soften through the front of your shoulders with each exhale. Down dog is a nice chest opener. One more breath. Good. Gaze forward. Travel your feet between your hands. Inhale. Find length through the back body. Exhale. Drop the front body over the legs. Inhale. Reach up towards the sky. Mountain pose. Exhale, lower the hands to heart center or down towards your hips. Good, two more rounds of those. Inhale, extend up. Exhale, folding forward. Linking breath with movement. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plant the palms, step it back, high plank, moving right into our chaturanga. Again, knees can lower or stay lifted here. Inhale, upward facing dog, roll the shoulders back, lift the head. And exhale, take it back, downward dog, pause, two breaths. Breathing in and out through the nose. Ujjayi breath, creating a little bit of sound with your breath. It should kind of sound like a whisper. One more round. And at the bottom of the breath, gaze forward. Step or hop the feet between the hands. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, fold towards the toes. Inhale, reach up, mountain pose. Exhale, hands lower down. Great job, last round. Inhale, sweep up. Exhale, dive down. Inhale, lengthen halfway. Press the big toes down. Good, exhale. Plant the palms, take it back. Chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. Roll the balls of the shoulders back. And exhale, flip onto the feet, downward facing dog. One breath. Good. Inhale, lift the right leg. Exhale, step it between the hands. Inhale, reach your right hand up towards the sky. Gaze up towards the thumb. Good.
Bend a little bit more into your front knee. Get a little bit lighter on your left hand. Very nice. And then spiral open a little bit more. One more breath. As you exhale, plant the right hand down. Step your left foot to meet the right foot at the top of the mat. Inhale, chair pose. Reach the arms up. Press the palms together. Good. Hold here. 3, 2, and 1. Straighten the legs. Fold forward. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, listen closely. Step your right foot towards the back of the mat nice and gracefully. Plant the palms to frame your front foot. Inhale, reach the left arm up and open. Twisting open through the left side body and the left shoulder. Take one more breath. And as you exhale, step it back. This time, plant your left hand. Step it into a high plank. Lower into a chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Pause. One round of breath. Inhale, lift the right leg up. Exhale, knee to the nose. Inhale, three-legged dog. Exhale, right knee to right elbow. Try and get it as high as you can. Good. Inhale, send it back, three-legged dog. Exhale, right knee to left elbow across the body. Strong side body. Inhale, send it back, three-legged dog. And this time, exhale, step it between your hands. Plant the back foot. Inhale, open up, warrior two. Finding a straight line with the arms. Softening the shoulders. Feel inside the body. Straighten the front leg. Ground your big toe of the front foot down into the mat. Inhale, reverse triangle. Reach your right arm back. Stretch through the right side body. As you exhale, come back forward, triangle pose. Right hand can come to the ankle, fingertips can come to the ground. For more advanced practitioners, peace fingers can come to the big toe. Left arm is reaching up towards the sky. At the same time, crown of the head is lengthening towards the front of the mat. For 3. Soften here, find stillness. 2. Good. And 1, keep your feet where they are. Lower the left hand down to the mat. If you need to step your feet a little bit closer together, go ahead and do so. We're moving into revolved triangle. Left hand is going to plant either on the inside or the outside of the front foot. When you're ready, inhale, reach the right arm up and open. Press firmly through your left hand. Soften through the right hip. Feel the stretch going down through that right side of the leg all the way up to the hip. Breathe. 3, 2. Good job. And 1. Lower the right hand down to the ground. From here, we're going to step the back foot forwards, coming into a standing split, lifting the back leg. Fingertips are framing the front foot. Good. From here, plant the left hand down. Reach the right arm up towards the ceiling. So we're coming into a revolved half moon pose. Now try and keep your left leg firmly pressing through the heel. So left toes are pointing down to the ground. Good. Spiral open through top shoulder. 3. If you feel steady, gaze up towards the hand. 2. Good. And 1. Slowly bring the right fingertips down. Keep the left leg lifted. Good. And then we're going to slowly come all the way up to stand, keeping that left foot lifted. Very nice job. Find your balance. From here, bring your right hand to grab the outer edge of your left foot. reach your left arm behind you. And then if you feel steady, start to straighten your left leg out in front of you. So left leg doesn't have to be all the way straight, as much as you can do today. Good, and if you feel very steady, you can gaze back towards your left fingertips. Breathe. 3, 2, and 1. Very nice job. Slowly come back to center. Lower the left foot to meet the right foot. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Press the palms. And as you exhale, fold forward. Let that go. Inhale, lengthen halfway. And exhale, plant the palms. Step or jump back, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Firm the thighs, firm the glutes. And exhale, take it back, downward facing dog. Pause here, deep breath in. Sigh it out. Inhale, lift the left leg high. Exhale, knee to the nose, curl it in. Inhale, send it back, three-legged dog. Exhale, left knee to left elbow. Maybe even tap the left shoulder if you can. Inhale, send it back. Exhale, across the body, left knee to right elbow. Good. Inhale, three-legged dog. Exhale, step it between the hands. Spin the back foot flat. Inhale, rise up, warrior two. Soften the shoulders. In these poses, we want to release any unnecessary tension, even in a very active pose like warrior two. See if you can relax the wrists, relax the muscles in your face. Let the breath be nice and smooth. Straighten the front leg. Inhale, reverse, reach the left arm back. Exhale, bring it forward, triangle pose, Trikonasana. Take a couple moments to set up. Anchor equally through both your front foot and your back foot. Extending up through the right arm. Pause. Stillness. Breathe. 3 breaths. One more breath. Very nice job. Lower the right hand down. Again, if you want to slide your back foot a little bit closer, feel free. So the closer the feet are in revolved triangle, the easier it's going to be. But if you're very comfortable in this pose, I challenge you to bring the feet a little bit wider than what you're used to doing. So setting up here, right hand comes to the inside or the outside of your front foot. Grounding firmly through that front foot and the front palm, as well as the back foot, strong foundation as the left hand reaches up and open. Very nice job. Soften through the left hip. Option to gaze up towards the top hand. 3. Deep breaths. 2. Good. And 1. Lower the left hand down. Frame your front foot with your fingertips. Step the back foot forwards. Standing split. Back foot lifts off of the mat. Try and bring your torso and your lifted leg parallel to the ground. Lifted toes are pointing down. Heel of the lifted foot is pressing towards the back of the mat. Find length through the spine. Very nice. From here, plant the right hand down. You can even be on the right fingertips if that's easier for you. Left arm reaches up, revolved half moon. Good. Opening through the shoulder. Option to bring the eye gaze up. Steady. 3. Maybe gaze up. 2. And 1. Slowly bring that left hand back down. Good. Very gracefully. Here we come.
all the way up to stand, keeping that right foot lifted, bending the right knee in front of you. Great job. Pause here. Right hand can come to the right hip to start off. Left hand is going to grab the outside of the front foot. And at your own pace, starting to straighten that leg as much as you can. Right hand can reach behind you. Maybe bring the eye gaze behind you. Bring your awareness to the foundation of your bottom foot. Nice and steady. 3, 2, and 1. Slowly bring the eye gaze back forwards as you lower the foot down. Inhale, sweep the arms up. And as you breathe out, fold forward. Great job. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plant the palms, step or jump it back, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Good job. Gaze forward, step or hop the feet between the hands. Inhale, straight into halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, chair pose. Bring the hands to heart center. Take a deep breath in. As you exhale, we're going to twist to the right side. Left elbow hooks across that front knee. So this is our first option in this revolved chair pose. If you want to play, we're going to play with our side crow. Hands can plant on the mat. So my fingertips are facing the right side of the mat. I'm bringing my outer right leg as high up on my left arm as I can. Right, my arm is going to be the shelf for my legs here. Bending the elbows, maybe lifting the legs. Squeeze the elbows towards each other. Good. Yeah, and if you're comfortable here, option to straighten the legs. 3, 2, 1. Slowly tracing your steps back into chair pose. Inhale, reach the arms up. And exhale, straighten the legs, fold forward, step the feet about hips width distance apart. Nice job, friends. Wherever you went, I commend you. Good work. Peace fingers, grab big toes. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Soften the shoulders. Soften the space between your shoulder blades. Two more breaths. Release the big toes. Bring your big toes to touch again. Inhale, chair pose. Reach the arms up. And then bring the hands to heart center. Take a deep breath in here. Exhale, twisting to the left side. As you twist, try and keep your knees in line with each other. The right knee is going to want to come forward. See if you can pull it slightly back. Good. So again, pause here in this revolved chair pose or option to play with the side crow. So again, hands are going to plant, bringing that left knee as high as you can. Slowly, at your own pace, bending the elbows, eye gazes forward, feet lift, hold, strong arms, option to straighten the legs, 3, breathe, 2, and 1. Nice job, slowly coming back to center. Inhale, one breath, chair pose, reach up, and exhale, let it go, fold forward. Again, step the feet shoulder width distance apart. This time, slide the palms of the hands under the soles of the feet. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. 3 breaths. Last breath. Good. Release the hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, go ahead and plant the palms. Take it through a vinyasa. And we'll meet back in downward dog. Once you're in down dog, drop the knees to the ground. Go ahead and make your way onto your back. As I promised, time for our relaxation, our deep stretching. The hard work is done. Great job. Plant the heels next to the hips. Lift the hips, bridge pose. Interlace the fingertips. Crawl the shoulder blades towards each other. Breathe deeply into the belly. Feel the sensation of the breath as it fills up the belly and as it goes back out. Good. Keep anchoring through the heels. See if you can lift the hips a couple inches higher. One more breath. Slowly lower onto the back. Hug the knees into the chest. Rock a little side to side. Massage your low back. From here, cross your right ankle on top of your left thigh, right below the knee, coming into a figure four stretch. I like to thread my right hand through the inner right knee. Kind of that little gap that you create with your right leg. Interlace fingertips and then grab the back of the left knee, but anything that's comfortable. If you have very open hips, sometimes it's really nice to kind of cradle that right shin bone to really, you know, be able to get that extra stretch in. Whatever is comfortable for you. About five rounds of breath here. Allow the energy to begin to soften. Allow the breath to slow down. Two more breaths. Yoga is a game of push and pull. We push our bodies hard. We test our limits on a physical level and a mental level. And then we pull in the opposite direction. We slow things down. These passive poses wouldn't feel as good as they do if we didn't push ourselves to our limit before we enter this state of surrender. When you're ready, we'll switch legs. Left ankle crosses on top of right thigh. So this hip might be a little bit more open for me. This is a much more flexible side, so you can adjust accordingly to your body. Notice as the heartbeat begins to slow down. Notice the quality of your mind. Again, there's no right and there's no wrong. Just observing your experience as it is without trying to change it. One more breath. And release. Straighten both legs. Roll all the way up to a seated position. Big toes are together. Inhale, sweep the arms up. And exhale, fold forward, Paschimottanasana. Inhale, lengthen your low back. Gaze forward. Exhale, fold forward. Take one more breath. And then slowly roll all the way up. Make your way onto your back. Hug the knees into the chest.
And from here, go ahead and straighten the legs. We're gonna make our way into a plow pose, if that's comfortable for you. Legs drop behind the head. Option to interlace the fingertips. As you crawl the shoulder blades together, kind of just like how we did in bridge pose, creating a little bit of space in the upper back between the shoulder blades. From here, bring the hands to the low back, lift the legs up, shoulder stand, creating a straight line from the tips of your toes down to the chest. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. One more time, plow pose, legs drop behind the head. Maybe coming a little bit deeper if it feels okay. Good, and then a quick Karna Pedasana, knees bend towards the sides of the head. Two breaths. Soften the neck. When you're ready, slowly rolling out onto the back. Left knee is gonna extend forward. Right knee hugs into the chest. Inhale. Exhale, supine twist. Right knee drops open to the left side. Right arm opens to the right. Gazing over that right shoulder. And coming back to center, switching legs. Inhale. And let the air out, supine twist. Good, inhale, come back to center. Hug both knees together, wrap the arms around the legs. One last squeeze, knees towards the forehead. Toes pull towards the shins. Deep breath in. Exhale, let it out. Release the legs. Open the arms. Shavasana pose. Getting nice and comfortable. Finding a shape that works for you, whatever that might look like. Allowing the eyelids to close. And just starting off by finding stillness inside your body. Allow the back of your head to be heavy. Allow the shoulder blades to melt into the mat. Fingertips are relaxed. Hips are melting down. Relax all the way through your ankles, all the way down through the tips of the toes. Take a deep inhale through the nose, fill up the belly. See if you're gonna fill up the side ribs. Feel the low back pressing down into the mat. Pause at the top of your breath. 3, 2, and 1. Big exhale, sigh it out your mouth. Allow everything to soften as you deflate and let go into the state of surrender. Take a deep inhale through the nose into the belly. Slow breath out the mouth. Wiggle the fingertips, wiggle the toes. Maybe make some circles with the wrists and the ankles. Bringing some movement back into the body. Inhale, reach the arms overhead. Grab one hand to the opposite wrist. Take a little side bend towards one side. And then switch. Opposite hand comes to opposite wrist. Side bend to the other side. Hug both knees into the chest. Roll onto either of your sides, right or left, fetal position. Ear rests on top of the shoulder. And slowly make your way up to a seated position. Eyes can remain closed. Any seated position is perfectly fine, whatever is most comfortable for you. Find a nice tall spine, lifting through the top of your head, and then grounding down through the shoulders, through the hips. Take a moment to notice how you're feeling in this moment compared to when you started your practice today. See if you can let in a little bit of gratitude in these final moments. Start with gratitude towards yourself. Be grateful towards yourself for showing up today, for putting in the time, the energy to nourish your body, to fill yourself up on a spiritual level, on an emotional level, whatever draws you to this practice. And then feel some gratitude towards the practice itself, knowing you can always come back to your yoga practice. You can always come back to this headspace that you're in now. Bring the hands together at heart center, press the palms. Inhale through the nose, deep breath. Sigh it out the mouth. Let go. And when you're ready, blinking open the eyes, namaste. Thank you so much, friends, for joining me on this practice today, this wonderful journey. I hope you feel good, energized, and relaxed. Again, my name is Mike. I plan to be uploading at least one video per week for the foreseeable future. So hit the subscribe button if you'd like to see more videos. Hit me a like if you enjoyed it. And I always love to see your comments below. Again, thanks for practicing. I'll see you next time. Namaste.